Good afternoon. Thank you for being with us, everyone. It's a good day, PA. I'm Amy Kemp. Some of you in the audience may have hip problems and need surgery, but the good part, it's the 21st century, and many of those surgeries are now minimally invasive. Dr. Joseph Alhadeff is an orthopedic surgeon from OSS Health, and he's here to answer some questions for us today. So let's first talk about minimally invasive hip surgery, hip arthroscopy. Is it the same thing? They're two different things. What is this?
It can be considered the same thing.
Okay.
So we are able now to just get make a few small incisions about the hip, insert a fiber optic camera, and then a number of other surgical tools through the other portal, and do quite a few different procedures in and around the hip joint. So things that before would have taken a 4 or 5 inch incision, a lot more bleeding and post-op recovery now can be done, and people can be home walking the same day.
That's amazing that people can be walking the same day after that. What are some more advantages of this more minimally invasive approach?
So we can treat procedures that were not able to really be done before. Mm-hmm. Labral tears around the hip, which is similar to a labral tear in a shoulder or a meniscal tear in a knee that many people might be more familiar with. We can now treat those arthroscopically as well. That was something that really wasn't even able to be treated more than like 10 years ago because we just didn't have the equipment for it.
So 10 years ago, folks would just have to deal with that? Would they be in constant pain?
Yes, they would be limping, sometimes unable to work. A lot of times it was career ending for athletes because they weren't able to get back to their job or their profession. And now you hear about athletes having hip surgery all the time and sometimes back the same season.
Wow, so what a dramatic difference a decade makes.
Yes.
Really, that's so neat. Can you explain the procedure just a little bit more, what makes it so minimally invasive?
Sure. The whole key is around the camera and the arthroscopic tools that we use. So it's almost like playing a video game for the surgeon. We're able to put the camera inside, you're watching up on the screen what you're doing, and then you can see the anatomy inside the hip very well. The fluid we put in limits the amount of bleeding, so we can take pictures. I can show people afterwards what exactly happened during their surgery, so the patients get an understanding of, hey, what did you do exactly?
Wow, that's really cool. Yeah. Very cool. The thing is, what causes some of these tears, some of these injuries? Why are folks getting them? Where are they coming from?
Sure. So hip injuries fall into two major categories. One are the traumatic ones, and that's where, let's say, an athlete stretches too far or trips over a hurdle like a runner or sometimes gymnasts. We know the positions they get their legs into, and they may cause a tear of the cartilage. And then the other ones are developmental. People who have the shape of their femoral head or their hip joint is not entirely normal, and then over time they can develop kind of a degenerative tear that can also be very painful.
Are these things something that are very common?
Yes, it's more common than what we thought before. A lot of times we weren't able to diagnose it, so people just said, it's hip pain, and they attributed it to arthritis. Now we're able to get more advanced studies like MRIs that can show us the actual pathology, and we're seeing a huge increase in the number of hip arthroscopies and diagnoses that are being made.
Is surgery the only option for this? Can you do something like physical therapy, or you need the surgery?
No, it's not always surgery. And oftentimes it can be treated with sometimes just an injection. Sometimes we can do physical therapy. There are a few medications that we can use to help alleviate people's symptoms. And really, you have to talk to a hip specialist to figure out, okay, which is most appropriate for me.
Very good. So then if maybe we do, as you said, need to speak with a specialist, how can we reach you guys?
Sure. I work out of both our Mechanicsburg office and down in York, OSS Health. We're on the web. I'm sure they're going to put information on here at some point.
There,
and
up on the screen.
We have a call center. You can call in, get an appointment anytime. We also have urgent care that's open 7 days a week at both Mechanicsburg and York locations, so people can actually just walk in.
So the excuse, no more excuses not to look into surgery, no more excuses, and not even just surgery, but you said it could be treated some other way. So
right,
we can find
sometimes,
out.
I mean, if your hip is hurting and it hasn't been getting better after, let's say, 4 or 6 weeks, it's probably good to just check in with somebody and see if there's something that can be done. There's no reason to live with pain. You don't have to.
Oh, very true. Thank you, doctor, for being with us on the show today.